Srijan Agarwal. He's a student, a computer science student, yep. And he's going to talk about WikiToLearn. Yep. So how can we contribute and how it's useful for us. Yep. Let's give a round of applause.
I'll start with introducing myself. So I'm a computer science engineering student from Amrita University, India. I'm a mentor at FOSSAT Amrita. We are a student club at the university which contributes to open source software. I develop in JavaScript, PHP, and Python. I have been involved in the WikiToLearn community since 2015. I was a Google Summer of Code student in last year. And then from then onwards, I have been contributing to it. I was also a Google Coding Mentor for 5 students this year. Except that, I try to make some products. I have been working with a startup called Scapic and ThinkFoss. So I'll start with giving you an instance of what's the scene with the university at current age. So this is an image from Howard University from 2017. So the students are sitting and the number of blackboards and a professor is teaching them. This was the image from 1960s. A similar kind of situation with less number of blackboards and less number of students, with professors still teaching with the same methodology. And this is an image from long back time, from medieval period. Like, still a professor maybe is teaching with a group of students sitting around. So the problem with what students face in the current situation is that they study from a lot of different materials, but before the exam they face problems with having their notes at different places, maybe somewhere in the internet or at books, at different kind of books. A physics 1 book, physics 2 book, there are different reference material they refer to. So we did a lot of research and we found out the solution for this problem is basically this: to have a collaborative area where you can put all your notes together and create a textbook. So what basically WikiToLearn is? So WikiToLearn is an open source project that aims to create free, accessible and collaborative textbooks to the whole world. So it provides a platform where students and teachers, researchers, academicians together can reassemble their lecture notes and create it to their own way. They can create their textbooks in their personalized way. So why should you contribute to it? So we think it is really important that users contribute to the writing and the improvement of the content. Because unless and until the contents have been improving, the platform is of no use. So this is the only way any project can be successful and can grow. If the users don't contribute, the project won't grow. So the best way of getting a platform to work is more and more users to contribute to it. Your contribution can be as small as it could be, but it is always fundamental. The size of contribution doesn't matter, but it matters that you contribute to it. So it's a very awesome community. We are an open source organization, so we are at various places. So we normally chat on Telegram. So we are very friendly community. Our community is mostly based at Europe, in Italy specifically. So this is how you get when someone joins. So this is how they welcome you. So it's educational, since at the end of the day, when you are writing and summarizing your notes on a platform, it's the best way you can note to yourself that which portion of the notes you couldn't understand, which portion of the classroom you understood and which you didn't understand. So the portion which you didn't understand, you can go back and refer to other materials, and at the end of the day, you can understand a bit of the portion. It's always fun and getting engaged with such a diverse community. You get to work with developers around the world and get to travel to the sprints and hackathons and the meets that they have. So this was image from last KubeCon. So basically, we are a community under KDE organization. So since KDE has this KubeCon and Academy together, we collaborate with KDE on our own sprints. So the first one is the founder himself. His name is Ricardo. He works on CERN. He works at CERN, and the three of them basically works at CERN, and they are master students of physics. Who can contribute? So I'm a university student. I have a lot of work. I don't have time for this. So writing and summarizing on WikiToLearn, as I said, is the best way you can understand which portion of the class you didn't understand and which you understood clearly. So at the end of the day, when you go back and write on WikiToLearn your notes which you didn't understand, you can refer to other material, or you can talk to someone who can give you an insight on the portion which you didn't understand. I'm a professor. So we have collaborated with around 30 plus universities in Europe. And in Europe, the professors use it as a tool in their classroom. Basically, what they do is they give their lecture notes on WikiToLearn and ask the students to keep their notes on WikiToLearn as well, so they could understand which portion students didn't understand of his lecture. So it helps in getting awareness about understanding of his each lesson, and which gives him valuable feedback of his lesson. So this is the way professors in different universities are using it. I'm a coder. So the backend of WikiToLearn is basically MediaWiki. We are supported by Wikimedia Foundation, and the backend is on MediaWiki. It's basically PHP and PHP. So there are plenty of work to do on MediaWiki. We aren't contributing to MediaWiki core. We have our own version of MediaWiki, and we do a lot of extensions except what you see on Wikipedia. So our portal is completely different from what is Wikipedia or Wikiversity or Wikibooks. So we have our own portal, and we have a lot of extensions which are not available on Wikipedia. So we always need volunteers to contribute to the code of our project. Opportunities like Google Summer of Code, Season of KDE, and Google Coding. Since we are under KDE organization, we get around 6-7 Google Summer of Code slots for different projects which are related to WikiToLearn, of course, and part of MediaWiki as well. Season of KDE is a program similar to Google Summer of Code, which is not payable, but you get to work with developers for 3 months, and you get, if you complete the project, you get some goodies from KDE and a certificate. Google Coding is for pre-university students from age 13 to 17. We participate in Google Coding as well, which we give small tasks for students to get involved with the open source community. So, who makes WikiToLearn? As I said, that KDE and Wikimedia Foundation supports us and funds us. KDE are the sponsors. So our founder was basically a KDE developer from 15 years. From last 15 years, he's been contributing to KDE, and eventually he made WikiToLearn a platform under KDE. So by 15 years, I don't mean he is too old. He started contributing at the age of 10 or 11, so he's very young. So we have collaborated with around 30 plus European universities, 5 US universities, with UCL London, and 2 Indian universities as well. We are growing in Europe much because most of the students of our community are in Europe, in Italy specifically. We have been one of the main sponsors of the WikiToLearn is CERN. CERN is backing us with a lot of power. They give us their area to work on, our office, and to give sprints on. Our sprints happens at CERN itself. So every year at CERN, we do a sprint of all the community there. Constantium Gar, it's Italian, which provides us the infrastructure. Our infrastructure is provided by GAR, and many other colleges like UCL London, University of Barcelona, Princeton University. We have collaborated with this many universities, and students are regularly updating their material on the platform. I'd like to show a video if I can. Is there a jack or audio? No?
No.
No, it's fine. There's
no keyboard there.
No, it's fine, it's fine.
You can play from your laptop. Right?
Yeah, I just. Anyway, the sound is nice.
Can switch to internal.
It's fine, it's fine. The sound
internal
is
audio.
Most of the time, I get this question, why WikiToLearn? There are platforms like Wikibooks, Wikiversity, powered by Wikimedia Foundation. Then why WikiToLearn? The main problem with the platform like Wikibooks and Wikiversity is their software. The software behind them is quite clumsy, and it's not easy for the students and researchers to work on it. So in WikiToLearn, you can create your own personalized textbooks by, suppose, let's say I have a course on Princeton University of Physics 101 and a similar course at University of Barcelona Physics 101. So both the courses are togetherly present at one platform, and I want to take some part from Princeton as well as University of Barcelona. I can create my personalized textbook from that. So I can take both of the content and create my own textbook. So that's how we power the software. So that is not present in the Wikibooks and the Wikiversity. Plus, Wikimedia Foundation is helping with providing us contacts of different universities and helping with that. So, yep. We are a user group of Wikimedia Foundation. We are a MediaWiki user group. We are not directly involved with Wikimedia Foundation, but they support us with different things. We are under KDE.
Okay.
Yep.
Is there a particular reason why major contributors are in Italy?
Because they started, the founders, and basically this project was started at University of Milano at Italy by some 6 physics students and a professor. They had problems with sharing their notes, so they basically started with a wiki page, a normal wiki page, and they eventually grew this community into WikiToLearn. And since the most of the contributors currently are in Italy, most of the chapters are Italian, but it is growing and growing since we have collaborated with different US universities as well.
Okay, thank you.
Have you done any collaboration with the Khan Academy?
Not yet. We are in touch with them. We are in touch with courses like Khan Academy and as well as video lectures with the video MOOCs, with the MOOCs.
If somebody has stuff that is already I teach a class here. And I have my materials all on Wikipedia. How would I make that available?
So basically so most of the professors have their research papers and they work on LaTeX format and stuff. So we have our importers from we have specific software importers which can import from wiki pages with HTML, which text LaTeX format, and you can do it in our platform. So we have been receiving books from different researchers as well. So that are also present in our platform.
So I have stuff sitting on PB works right now.
Yeah, sure. I'll just catch you up.
Right.
Yep.
Yeah, so is it possible to clone or run our own instance of
WikiToLearn?
Yeah, WikiToLearn. Okay. Like I say, instead of going for academic things, maybe we're going to host instruction building Legos.
Yeah. So I can just show you how it looks like. This is how the portal looks like. So basically, when you make a course, you have an option to create a private or a public course. So when you do a private course, you can keep a private course until and unless you're good with yourself that you want it to be public. So you can keep it as a private, but that course is still available. You need to just give the URL to anyone and he can access it. But without URL, it can't access it. So it's private, but not private as in you can't access it. So what most professors do is they create a private course, and once the course for a semester has been completed, they keep it private and then they make it public.
What is the requirement to run our own instance?
So basically, instance means
host our own server.
So basically, this is a media wiki. It's a wiki page. So it's on the media wiki software. So you can maybe run your own wiki page on that. So if you want to basically run WikiToLearn, you have to do it. If you want to contribute, as in running locally, if you mean that, so there is steps to do that.
So I can download that.
Yeah, okay. So yeah, sure. Do you mean you want to? Yeah, I got it. I'll just show you. Yeah, I guess that he means that. So that's what MediaWiki does. So MediaWiki is the software which runs behind WikiToLearn, which helps you in creating wiki pages. Yep. So for that, we have a specific workshop after this talk at 2:30, right? Yeah, for setting up MediaWiki and helping contribute to MediaWiki as well.
We will be setting up the development workshop.
Development, yep.
Table
volunteer. Yep. But that will give you an insight on how to do that. This is where, our project is hosted on GitHub. It's github.com/wikitolearn. So since it is on MediaWiki, our most of the code base is on PHP and JavaScript. So, yeah. And it's push, yeah.
You actually kind of review process for the content.
Yeah, so we are on that. We have only launched the first version. In second version, we have been working on a review process where professors can review a specific material which someone edits. We have three badges for that. One will be the beginner, another will be the moderator, and a tutor. So basically, what moderator will do, it will moderate the content, what is being uploaded there, and if it feels it's correct, it would be public. Otherwise, if you want to keep it private, you can do that. We are in touch with different professors which are helping us doing that.